everyone, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Amy, and I'm currently on a journey to repay six figures worth of student loan debt. And every single Friday, I share our weekly progress towards our debt repayment, as well as any side hustle income that we receive that week. We put currently all of our side hustle income to debt, and as well as this is actually the last Friday in July, so we will be going over our July recap. We'll be going through all of our sheets. These are the normal sheets that we go over, the charts that we go over every single week. And then we'll also be going over our debt tracker and our yearly debt payoff tracker for the month of July. So to get started here, our original starting balance of my student loans was $132,404. We started this week with a balance of $33,400, which is at 74.77% paid off. This week, we were able to make a payment of $1,100, and that leaves our ending for this week at $32,300, which is hitting another milestone of 75.6% paid off. Woohoo! I am so excited. 75% paid off. That means we are three-fourths of the way through our debt-free journey. It has been a very long journey, and I am so ready to be debt-free, but we still have, you know, $30,000 to go. So trying to maintain realism here, you know, we're close, but we still have a long way to go. But I'm so proud of how much debt we have paid off and how far under our goal we have gotten this year. So we did revise our original goal, which was under $40,000 to under $20,000. So that is bringing us with a total of $12,300 to go, and that is to get to our 2021 goal of under $20,000. We have $12,000 to go. That is feels really realistic to me. We still have, you know, 5 months of the year left, so I definitely think that we can do that, and hopefully we will get even farther in our journey. Under 20 is really our goal, but as far under 20 as we can get would be incredible. So that is super exciting. It is really weird because I don't feel like this journey is almost over in a way, if that makes sense. Like, I know that it is logically, and like I film these videos every week, but like it just doesn't feel real yet. So I'm interested to see like when it will actually feel real, or if when we become debt-free, if it'll even feel real. I don't know. It's just so weird to like live your entire life being in debt and then have like see the light at the end of the tunnel. You know what I'm saying? So it's really fun. But so for side hustle income for this week, which was the 23rd through the 29th, I cut it off on the day that I film these videos, which is Thursday, so that I can post them on Friday. So our side hustle income for this week, we had two sources of side hustle income for this week. I made $75 on Facebook Marketplace. So if you've watched my other debt-free Friday videos from this month, you would know that I was trying to get out and do Instacart. Unfortunately, it just didn't happen with my husband's schedule and my schedule. We've just been really, really busy. So unfortunately, I did not get out and do Instacart at all this month, which was a little bit disappointing. But while I was sitting at home with my kids, I realized that I had some things in our basement that we could possibly sell. So we actually sold two items. They were like storage, like toy storage items that we've had sitting in our basement empty for like over a year. We just don't use them. And they were just taking up space. And I was like, you know what? I bet I can sell these. And sure enough, in like a couple hours, they both sold on Facebook and I made $75. So even though I didn't get out and do Instacart this month, that was kind of my supplement and my agreement with myself that, hey, if you're not going to do this other thing, find a way to make money at home. So I encourage you, if there are things in your house that you want to sell, just go do it. It's kind of a pain in the butt, but it's so worth it. Like, it really only took me probably about 10 minutes to just clean the items and then post them. And yes, it was a good process. And I'm very happy that I did it because we were able to beat our side hustle goal for the month, which we'll talk about in a moment. So, and then I also made $6.93 on Etsy. If you're new here, I do have a small Etsy shop. I always have it linked in the description below. All of these sheets that I have printed that I'm going to be going over today and more are all in my Etsy shop. So if you want to check those out, definitely do so. I so appreciate all of you guys that buy from my Etsy shop. It really helps. And seriously, even though it's only a few dollars, it really adds up And all of that goes to my debt. So I really truly appreciate it. On my last video, I got a couple of DMs actually that were asking how you guys can support my channel. And honestly, the biggest thing that you can do is watch and share my videos. I so appreciate you guys watching. It's free for you to do, and it really means a lot to me. That's probably the biggest thing that you can do. I do have a link down below for a buy me a coffee, which is kind of like a way to support my channel by buying me a coffee. It's like $5. Obviously I'm not going to buy coffee with that. I will be paying debt towards that. So if any of you want to use that link, it's there. Definitely don't feel obligated though. You guys being here and supporting me however you can is like seriously the best thing ever. I expect absolutely nothing out of you. So thank you for being here. And I just figured I'd address that because I did get a couple of DMs about it. And I thought that was so sweet that you guys were wondering how you can support me. But yeah, the biggest thing is just sharing and watching my videos. It really helps out my channel. So thank you guys so much as always for the support. So that brings our weekly side hustle total to $81.93. And then at the end of the month on my last debt-free Friday video, I always just do a side hustle recap of the month just to talk about all of our sources of side hustle income for the month and if we met our monthly goal. So our monthly goal for July was to get at least $250 worth of side hustle income. So I will just add up everything here. I actually haven't added it yet, but I know we met our goal because we had some bigger sources of side hustle income this month, which brought us over the total. So the first side hustle income that we had for the month was Achievement. This was talked about in one of my earliest July videos. Achievement is an app that I use. It just links to like your fitness watch, and you basically just get cash, or like you get points for like walking or entering food or weighing yourself, you know, like anything fitness related. And once you get 10,000 points, you can cash out. I cashed out in January and July, so it takes a long time, but it's one of those things that I don't actually ever log into it. I just leave it, and then every like few months, I kind of check in and see if I've hit my 10,000. So it's basically one of those like sit and, you know, it just kind of does its own thing. So that's cool. I really enjoy that app because, like I said, it's completely hands off. Then we made $26.56 from Etsy this month, which is awesome. I so appreciate you guys buying those things. As I said before, it really, really helps out with our debt payoff. Every single penny counts and definitely all adds up. As you can see, we have paid off a lot of debt. So then we have $94.15 from Surveys on the Go, which is amazing. I think that's the most we've ever made from Surveys on the Go in 1 month. So just absolutely incredible progress on that. I'm so excited. My husband and I both do Surveys on the Go. As I say in every video, we have absolutely no affiliation with Surveys on the Go. They don't know I exist or that I promote them almost every single week, but I do because we truly love it. And obviously we made almost $100 this month from Surveys on the Go. Granted, a couple of those payouts were from product reviews that my husband and I did. Those tend to be bigger payouts. So this is not like I would say our normal income from Surveys on the Go, but we typically have anywhere from like $25 to up to $94 a month that we get from Surveys on the Go. And it's fairly easy. It does take some time to do the surveys, but it's totally worth it in my opinion. Then we made that $75 from Facebook Marketplace. And my last source of side hustle income for this month was our AdSense YouTube revenue. That was $129.45 from AdSense. So those are all of our side hustle sources for this month. So I'm just gonna add these up really quick. Like I said, I did not add these up yet, but I'm curious to see exactly where we're at. Again, our goal was 250. So we made $335.16 in side hustle income this month. Super excited about that, over $300. That is one of our larger months for side hustle income. I so am just incredibly proud of that because it really all went towards debt and has allowed us to make these huge jumps in our debt payment journey. If you don't do any side hustles, I highly suggest starting a few. a lot of them are really easy, like achievement or surveys on the go, things that you can do at home that don't really take that much time, as well as selling on Facebook Marketplace is another great one. We've made a lot of money this year selling items on Facebook Marketplace that we just have taking up room in our house, you know? So I definitely recommend that you guys do that if you're trying to excel your debt payoff journey, because it definitely helps. So now we're going to get into all of our different charts. So the first things I'm going to go over are our freedom trackers. So for this week, I will be filling in 5.5 icons on our target loan chart. So this is the loan that we're currently targeting, which is my highest interest rate loan. It is my final grad school loan, and I will be filling in 5.5 on this one. And then I have our debt freedom tracker that I restarted January 1st, and I will be finishing the fifth row of this one, which makes this tracker halfway done, which is so amazing and exciting. That is awesome. So I will fill these in and then come back and chat with you guys. If only I had listened for a while, I would have told you I miss your smile. All right, so they are all colored in for this week. I'm so excited because we're also almost halfway done with this target loan tracker. This one's definitely going faster as the balance is smaller, but it's definitely fun to see the progress of this loan. Once this target loan is paid off, our debt-free journey, I feel like, is gonna go super fast. And then we have our debt freedom tracker. So excited to be halfway done with this tracker. We started this January 1st, so it's really fun to see how far we're progressing, and I cannot wait till it's completely filled up. And honestly, I might leave it on my fridge forever. I don't know if I will ever want to take it off my fridge after I have filled it out. I have put so much effort into this chart that I don't know that I'll ever have the ability to get rid of it, to be honest. All right, so next up is our debt freedom tracker. This is just another tool that I use to just keep track of my individual loans, as I do have 11 different loans through my provider. Even though I only have one loan balance per se, it is all broken out into a bunch of different loans. So if you're new here, this is the current loan that we're targeting. It was starting balance as of July 1st at $16,520. This is our current target loan. After this one is paid off, we will be switching to the debt snowball method, which I've used on and off before in different points in my journey. It just kind of depends on what we're feeling like at the time, to be honest. I have switched back and forth many times. However, that is just kind of what feels right to me at after this bigger loan is paid off. So once this one's paid off, we are switching back to the snowball method. So as you can see here, these are listed in order from smallest to largest, and then the interest rates kind of vary, but all of the interest rates of my remaining loans are under 5%, so that was kind of the deciding factor. This is still over 5%, so I preferred just to get this one paid off as soon as possible. So that being said, this is obviously the only loan that we are targeting right now, so our current balance after all of our July payments is actually $10,920. So super excited. That is huge progress for 1 month, and I'm very happy. We are so close to getting under $10,000 on that loan, and once we're under 10, I feel like it's going to go really fast. So that brings our total, so our starting balance as of July 1st was $37,900. Our current balance, as we just went over, is $32,300. So we've made amazing progress this month. This month was a 5-paycheck month for my husband and I. We both get paid bi-weekly, so every few months, one of us gets an extra check, which is incredible and super helpful for journeys like this where we could use all the extra money we can get. So down here, I just wrote our July payment recap. So if you've watched all my Debt Free Friday videos, you probably recall all of these payments, but these are just all of the Fridays of the month and all the payments that we made. And that is for a total of $5,600 worth of payments. Wow. That is one of our biggest months ever. It just feels really good to be able to put that much money towards debt. As much as it feels good, it also feels weird and kind of like, ugh, you know, like that's a lot of money, but I'm so, so happy that we started this journey, and I never, ever regret a day of paying off debt. I truly don't, even though sometimes it can feel a little overwhelming just based on how much we have paid. So then I'm gonna go to our debt summary. So as we kind of talked about already, our total starting debt was $132,404. Our current debt is $32,300, which means that to date we have paid $100,104. So another milestone we hit this month is hitting $100,000 paid off. That is incredible, and like I can't even believe that I'm saying it out loud. We have paid off $100,000 of debt. What? That's like some people's mortgages. It just feels crazy. But it also feels good because I know that we're on the end of our journey, and we hitting that $100,000 milestone just feels really good. So we are obviously 75% of the way done. Wow, $100,000 paid off. So crazy. I can't even believe it. It just feels surreal, honestly, but super good. So I'm not going to go over our debt-free plan. I kind of do that like every couple of months. Obviously, you know that our biggest goal for the year is to get under 20,000. So we don't really have any necessarily any specific three, 6 or 1 year goals besides just getting out of debt. So we're not going to fill out that today. And our last tracker for this video is our yearly debt payoff tracker. This is just another tracker that I like to use so that I can just keep track of all of our payments for each month. I also do a similar one on my Instagram. I have a template if you're curious, or if you want it, DM me. I can send you the clean version, but I do fill it out every single month as well. So starting for July was $37,900. Payments for this month was $5,600, and our ending is $32,300. Wow, that is so crazy. So as you can see, our payments have varied a little bit every month. March was our lowest month because that is actually the month that we purchased our vehicle. So our we did have to put a little bit extra towards that purchase. So our debt payments were a little bit lower. However, they typically hang anywhere from like $3,000 to $5,000, kind of depending on the month. January was our biggest month because we did have a tax refund and a bonus and some other additional income in that month. We had one of our probably highest income months that month. So, wow, I can't believe it. And I also can't believe that we only have 5 more months of this. So it'll be a little bit bittersweet to say goodbye to this yearly debt payoff tracker and hopefully our last full yearly debt payoff tracker, because I hope to be debt-free by May of next year. So that is all I have for you guys today. Let me know in the comments down below what you did to move yourself financially forward this week, and I will talk to you next week. Bye, guys.